Hey guys, welcome back. So now jumping back into more talk about Doomsday Clock, there's a few things I wanted to get into in this video, and a lot of it has to do with Rorschach, and those things being his death, his replacement if you will, and the signs that we've seen thus far possibly leading up to his return. So we're gonna dig into that with a lot more Doomsday Clock madness as well. But first, if you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe to catch the spills every week, and don't forget to hit that bell up top so we can squat up in the comments for the first hour. Alright, so previously on this playlist, we had talked about the events that had taken place in the Watchmen universe, and focusing heavily more so from like 1985 forward with the death of the Comedian, who we'd later come to find out had been killed by Ozymandias, who had his own twisted view on how to bring world peace, but a huge part of that was getting rid of the world's superheroes. But with Ozymandias killing the Comedian, this quickly sparked the curiosity of Walter Kovac, aka Rorschach, who had followed the crumbs, so to speak, with the assistance of Night Owl, and as a result, like every finger in this conspiracy was pointing back to Ozymandias, whose act of genocide did bring world peace, but with Rorschach knowing the truth to which he had logged in his journal, Rorschach was then a threat to this world peace because he wanted the world to be informed of this lie rather than have Ozymandias get away with the murder of millions. But in the eyes of Dr. Manhattan, who at this point had finally been filled in on everything that Ozymandias had done, but Manhattan had seen it as a deed for the greater good to stop Rorschach from spreading the truth because that would have undone all the peace that had been accomplished, to which Dr. Manhattan had deemed greater than just making sure that Ozymandias had paid for what he had done. But to step back just a little bit to a conversation that had taken place between Dr. Manhattan and Ozymandias, to where we see Dr. Manhattan had a disturbance seeing this very moment. And usually he can look all throughout time like it's all laid out on one canvas, but prior to the moment with him killing Walter Kovac, he couldn't see who it was because that particular image of that moment, though he could vaguely see that it was one that was coming, it was one that he perceived with much static and very unclear, but Dr. Manhattan did not know why. Which was one of the first times that he looked into the future and could not see it clearly. And this is one of the things that we'll come back to because it could possibly be one of the earliest hints that Rorschach, Walter Kovac, is still alive. And we'll get into more of that in just a little bit. But as we know from there, Dr. Manhattan had left, and we had followed much of those events in the last two videos. But staying here in the Watchmen universe, fast forward to 1992, and at this point in time, the truth of what Ozymandias had done, it had reached the headlines and had taken a drastic effect in the opposite direction, causing nuclear retaliation from opposing countries, which you could imagine just threw everybody else into panic because of all the fear, anger, and confusion from knowing this ugly truth. But also with the world finally knowing how this came about, this also made Ozymandias the most wanted man on the face of the planet, which also caused him to go into hiding. But also during this time in the Watchmen universe, we come across another Rorschach who has snuck into prison to break out Marionette and Mime. And it's early on, like when he first meets Erica Manson, the Marionette, that he tells her early on that he's not Walter Kovac. And so to quickly gain her trust, because they had like 36 minutes before nuclear holocaust, and the previous Rorschach had threatened to kill her, so he just quickly showed her his hand to prove that he wasn't Walter Kovac and get them out of there without all the long explanations. But after retrieving Marionette and Mime, he takes them back to the old secret lair of Night Owl, telling them that his partner is going to help them find their son. But it's upon their arrival to the old hideout of Night Owl that we find out that he's worked with Ozymandias, who also has with him Bubastis, who was actually a clone of the original Bubastis. And so now the way that this came about, first with Bubastis and then about how Rorschach and him started working together. But as far as Bubastis, Ozymandias had tricked Dr. Manhattan into going back into the intrinsic field subtractor with Bubastis, who he ended up cloning, and initially with the motive of framing Dr. Manhattan, but as a plus, after cloning Bubastis, he was able to use that unique energy signal from Dr. Manhattan in order to follow him or even to call him if need be. Which is pretty much why when everything went left, Bubastis too, for lack of a better name, never left the side of Ozymandias after Dr. Manhattan went ghost up until now. But as far as the new Rorschach and how him and Ozymandias started working together, his real name is Reggie Long, and he's the son of Dr. Malcolm Long, who at one point in time was a psychiatrist for Rorschach, the original Rorschach, to whom his father had believed there was hope for. And at the time that the mass genocide had taken place on the world of the Watchmen, Reggie's parents were both killed, but with Reggie being far enough away, he had survived the blast by just a few feet. And he was still shooken up, but he was amongst the thousands within that area who had still survived. But not long after from here, he was taken over to the crazy house because of these certain visions he would see, but it was here that he had met the original Mothman, aka Byron Lewis, to whom over a period of time time, had befriended Reggie and taken him under his wing, so to speak, no pun intended, but it was in this time that they'd shared here that he had taught Reggie to fight, and not like full-blown training, but he showed him a thing or two. But it was also in addition to this time that they were in there together when the news had broke about Ozymandias and how Ozymandias was the cause of the mass genocide that was masked to look like it was Dr. Manhattan, and it was soon after that Byron and Reggie had broken out. But upon their escape, which was orchestrated by setting some laundry on fire so that they can make their escape during the fire evacuation, it was also here that Byron the Mothman had fell victim to a reoccurring theme throughout the Doomsday Clock series, to whereupon when he looked back on the fire, he was drawn to it like a moth to a flame, and because he couldn't resist, he walked right into it being burned alive. But this was very symbolic to Reggie and many others, I believe even including Dr. Manhattan, because many of the individuals in this narrative share the similarity that they are looking for something or they are being drawn towards something, whether it be a literal flame, the answer to a greater purpose, or even a future that you can't see. But Byron had also left for Reggie the means to get to the destination that held his answers, with the addition of an old mask from Walter Kovac, and letting Reggie know that when he gets there, what he sees is what matters. And this map that Reggie was given by Byron, and this map that Byron had given Reggie, had actually led him to the Antarctic hideout of Ozymandias, who had pretty much told Reggie that he had realized what he had done was wrong. He had shown Reggie x-rays of him having brain cancer, and he had also told Reggie that he had seen the light too late, which for Reggie was like that fourth affirmation, with the first light being from the incident which killed his parents, the second light from the burning fire that Byron couldn't resist and he had walked right into, which ultimately took his life, the third light being the reference in the letter from Byron to Reggie, and the fourth being the words of Ozymandias, who claimed he had seen the light after everything was said and done, and ultimately being diagnosed with brain cancer. But it was these things, these events, that played a factor in making Reggie easier to persuade to assist Ozymandias in order to find Dr. Manhattan, and then in the case of Marinette and Mime, he had told them if they assist him in finding Dr. Manhattan, then he would with certainty help them find their son. And so to do so, Ozymandias of course brought along Bubastis so they can find Dr. Manhattan and modify Night Owl's old ship so that it could handle the ride, follow Manhattan's energy signature, and take them to this new universe, which they literally crossed over into at the moment when the nuclear missiles were touching down in their world, and barely getting out in time in order to cross over into this new universe. And so it's not too long after their arrival here, in Gotham City, which couldn't have been visually more epic, like flying through the bat signal. But it's with their arrival here that they make a discovery that could possibly be hinting towards Rorschach still being alive. And so now mind you, when they get here in Gotham City, at this current time around the world, the whole Superman theory is going crazy, with the majority of heroes being from the US and the world believing that a lot of them was manufactured, almost to the fashion of like a nuclear deterrent. And upon the time of their arrival, much of the controversy has recently been turned on Batman. But after their rough landing, Ozymandias takes this opportunity to handcuff Marinette and Mime, so that he can take Reggie and do a little research about this new world, and do so without a couple of loose cannons by his side. And the first place that they go together is to the Gotham City Public Library. And while seeming to push through his migraines during his terminal illness, Ozymandias tells Reggie that they need to find the two smartest people on this planet, and it's here that they quickly discover that those two people are Bruce Wayne and Lex Luthor. And Ozymandias, for obvious reasons, calls dibs on Lex Luthor, which leads Reggie to look for Batman. And with going to the Wayne Manor to see Bruce Wayne, it doesn't take Reggie long to one, eat his breakfast, but two, also figure out the Batcave. But it's like, you know when Batman's fighting crime all night, I bet you like he's out there just thinking, man, wait till I get home and get these pancakes. Like, I think that's one of those things that really gets him through those tough nights. But all in all, Reggie's arrival here, of course, triggers a silent alarm that notifies Batman to come back, and Reggie gives Batman the journal of Walter Kovac, which was in his coat, sitting right next to the fork that I think he stole after eating his pancakes. But nonetheless, getting Batman caught up with everything that has gone on thus far. But now in the case of Ozymandias meeting with Lex Luthor, this moment had to be one that sparked most of my curiosity pertaining to the possible return of Rorschach. Because when Ozymandias comes here to meet with Lex Luthor, who more or less responds like, who the hell are you and why are you in my office? It is at this time shots are fired, and I told y'all Ozymandias is quick. But when these shots are fired and he jumps out of the way and Luthor's hit, much to Ozymandias' surprise, this was a sneak attack by the comedian, to whom I had mentioned in the previous video had been saved by Dr. Manhattan while falling from his window, and just before falling to his death, Dr. Manhattan had brought him to this universe. And so now I believe, and one of the things I've been building up to, especially with the references from before Watchmen, which is when we initially get Dr. Manhattan having trouble seeing the future, and one of those first instances instances being not able to see himself killing Rorschach. But what I believe this all means, and we'll find out for sure in the next few weeks, but what I believe this all means is, one, when Dr. Manhattan interferes with time, which is something he can usually see all in one setting, but when he pulls something out of one place or pushes something in another spot in another place, like a lantern for instance, like, one, these causalities will have other effects, but Manhattan will not be able to see what's the outcome of those effects, at least not with perfect clarity, if not at all. But with his actions having a cause and effect, the cause of him even saving the comedian, it may have as a result inadvertently saved Rorschach's life, and the distortion that Dr. Manhattan had seen when Rorschach had died may have been because that event never happened at all, because it was the comedian's death that ultimately led him on this journey to which in the end would cause him his life. But whether he's in the Watchmen world, surviving in some post-apocalyptic bunker, like, who knows? If anything, he'd probably be in the old hideout of Ozymandias in Antarctica. But I wouldn't be surprised if at some point, Walter Kovac returns sooner than later, leading everyone to believe that he was actually Reggie, and then when people see Reggie and Rorschach at the same time, it's like this mind-blown reveal, which would be crazy. But as far as Ozymandias, he barely escaped the attack of the comedian, and having to do so by leaping from the window, which is a real close call for some poetic justice. But that'll do it for this one, guys. But I gotta give some of you props, because in my last Doomsday Clock video, a couple of you kinda saw where I was going with this, and you kinda forced my hand to switch things up a little, because I was gonna go Superman first. But much props to you guys for peeping this out, putting your detective cowls on and figuring it out. And y'all was quick. It was like in a squad hour too. It was crazy. But that's it for this one. Let me know your thoughts down in the comments below. Do you believe Kovac's still alive? And how would you like to see his return? But let me know down below, and we'll do it again in the next one. All right, later.